Thank you. Welcome to the Greater Los Angeles Area Council's Distinguished Citizen Award event honoring Jeff Keitlinger. Jeff is well known for service as General Manager and Chief Executive Officer of the Metropolitan Water District of Southern California, a role from which he retired from in July. I am John Johnson, President and Chairman of the Board for Greater Los Angeles Area Council, Boy Scouts of America. Our council serves one of the largest and most diverse populations in America, each year positively impacting the lives of up to 25,000 youth. Scouting supports young people in their physical, mental, and spiritual development with an emphasis on learning by doing, most often in the medium of the outdoors. This hands-on, self-reliant, values-based approach to learning creates scouting experiences that teach our youth responsibility, character, decision-making skills, builds confidence, environmental conservation, trustworthiness, leadership, readiness, and personal honor. Scouting builds character, and it could not be accomplished without the support of the more than 4,000 dedicated volunteers in our community. Especially in times like today, where we are separated by space and distance and so very divisive, the collaborative and inclusive message of scouting is more important than ever, and we collectively must help distill those values in our youth. We in Greater Los Angeles are proud of the platform that scouting provides and in our partnership with the Metropolitan Water District. I have had the opportunity and privilege to know and work with our honoree, Jeff Keitlinger, on a personal level. Our sons are Eagle Scouts from the same troop, and as a scoutmaster have gone on many outings together, including touring the Hoover Dam, arranged by Jeff, on an annual Colorado River canoe trip. The Master of Ceremonies for this evening's Distinguished Citizens Award is a dear friend of our Jeff Keitlinger. Richard Katz has served in the California State Assembly for 16 years. Following his time in elected office, Richard continued in public service in many capacities, including on the California State Water Resources Control Board, the LA Metropolitan Transportation Authority, Metrolink Board of Directors, and the LA City Planning Commission. Mr. Katz, thank you for your service to our community and for your service tonight in honoring Jeff.
Thank you, John, and thanks to everyone who's made tonight a special evening. I'm honored to be part of this celebration tonight for a good friend who richly deserves this award. I've known Jeff quite a while, and when I was the lead negotiator for California on the quantification settlement agreement, Jeff led the charge for MWD, and without his leadership and vision, we would have never achieved that landmark agreement.
The Distinguished Citizen Award event is possible through the support of our generous sponsors. Diamond Valley Lake sponsors include the Association of California Water Agencies, Bruce G. Davis and Davis Bacon, Timothy Greenleaf, John O. Johnson and the Spartan Group, Brian Matthews and Payton and Rigel, Nancy and L. Playman, Von Skoyak and Associates. Colorado River Aqueduct sponsors include the Cordoba Corporation, Metropolitan Water District of Southern California, the City of Pasadena, the City of San Marino, California American Water, Upper San Gabriel Valley Metropolitan Water District, the Three Valleys Metropolitan Water District, and the Foothill Metropolitan Water District. Colonel Jack Foley sponsors include the Eastern Municipal Water District, Nimala Pappas and Associates, West Basin Municipal Water District. Thank you all for your support, and for a complete list, please see our tribute book.
The Scouting Program reminds young people to do their duty to God and country. We will start our event with an invocation. Immediately following the invocation, a diverse group of scouts and explorers from the Greater Los Angeles Area Council will lead a patriotic opening ceremony.
Please prepare yourself in the manner in which you are accustomed to for the invocation.
What is that, parents and teachers and leaders and all the members of Scouting? What is your thing you have for us? Help us to be a better Scouts and let us do our best for you. Amen.
Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. If you're in uniform, please salute. If not, put your hand over your heart.
I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America.
And to the Republic for which it stands.
One nation, under God.
Indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Now for the Scout Oath.
On my honor, I will do my best to do my duty.
To obey the Scout law, to help other people at all times.
So physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight.
Please join me in the Scout law.
A Scout is trustworthy, loyal,
friendly, courteous,
kind, obedient, cheerful, thrifty, brave, clean, and reverent.
Thank you, Scouts. I'm going to talk a little about a few of Jeff Keitlinger's lifetime achievements and civic duties that affect the great majority of you watching our program right now as regards water conservation. Jeff is an Eagle Scout who earned the award when he was 16 years old while in Troop 118 in Glendale, California. Scouting introduced Jeff to the idea of environmental responsibility, and there began his lifelong passion for water conservation and what he has dedicated his entire career towards.
Hi, I'm Los Angeles County Supervisor Catherine Barger. It is an honor to join you for the Greater Los Angeles Area Council's Distinguished Citizen Award celebration. Congratulations to Jeff on this well-deserved recognition. It's evident that your time as a Scout has greatly influenced your dedication to a lifetime of community service. By using the values you learned as an Eagle Scout and your expertise with the Metropolitan Water District, you've helped propel the next generation of Scouts to be good stewards of their resources. Thank you for leading the way for Scouts in Los Angeles County to learn about sustainability by getting valuable hands-on experience. As someone who comes from a family full of Scouts, I've seen how the lessons my loved ones learned impacted the rest of their lives. I know the knowledge you've shared through your Water Conservation Merit Badge Day will serve our youth for many years to come. Thank you, Jeff, for pouring into LA County youth. Your thoughtful leadership and support of Scouting has made a meaningful difference in our community.
Jeff has an undergraduate degree from University of California, Berkeley, and a law degree from Santa Clara University. He serves on a number of boards, including the Coral Foundation, the USC Price School of Public Policy, the UCLA Sustainability Advisory Board, the Climate Action Reserve, the California Foundation on the Environment and the Economy, the Los Angeles Economic Development Council. If you're in the water world, you might recall that in 2006, Jeff and I ran against each other for the position of general manager at MWD. It was an interesting process. Jeff's interview lasted about 15 minutes, and my interview was 45 minutes, most of which was Randy Record playing whack-a-mole with me. The board, in the end, decided to go with Jeff. It was a great decision because of the leadership Jeff's shown, and I, for one, have been forever grateful that Jeff got that job. You know, it's evident as you look around today and we're confronting what is our new normal, which is severe drought, not as an occasional occurrence, but as a regular occurrence. And I think it says a lot about Jeff's leadership that MWD and Southern California is positioned this year to have more water available for their constituents than Northern California. Not something that happens often and something we hear from the North about quite a bit. But I'm not saying that to brag we're doing a better job. I'm saying that in recognition of the outstanding work that Jeff and the MWD board did on behalf of all the people who live and work in Southern California. We'd like to show a video tribute to Jeff from Senator Dianne Feinstein. Senator Feinstein, longtime advocate for water solutions and updating the state's water supply and infrastructure, has worked closely with Jeff for many, many years. They've worked together on conservation, on supply issues, on providing more infrastructure for California water. This video was recorded by the senator for Jeff's retirement from MWD.
His steady and major leadership has been really invaluable when we worked with the federal government and California to resolve extremely complex water and environmental issues. Oh, Jeff, I'm so thankful for your hard work on these and many other California water issues, and also for your friendship over all these years. I hope you enjoy, oh, and I hate to say this, your much deserved retirement, and get out to see Dodgers win, except when they play my Giants.
Hello, friends of Jeff Keitlinger and friends of Scouting. On behalf of the Scouts and volunteer leaders of Greater Los Angeles Area Council, I want to thank you for participating in this event. Your presence is a statement that you believe in the future of our country, that you believe in the young people of our nation, and by being here, you are showing the young people in Scouting that you believe in them and have faith that they can make the world a better place as a leader and a citizen. The Scout motto is "Be prepared." While some may think it's a reference to preparing for a storm, or by bringing camping gear on a campout, or by being ready to provide life-saving skills, it's much more than that. What it really means is to be prepared for life. Scouting helps boys and girls prepare for life by teaching them to be good citizens and training them to become leaders. Merit badges are one of the hallmarks of the Scouting program. This ubiquitous badge is much more than a piece of cloth. It represents hundreds of skills that our Scouts can learn in Scouting. Today, there are over 130 different subjects covered by the Merit Badge program. Topics such as astronomy, cooking, auto repairs, and citizenship. With the financial support provided through tonight's event, we plan to expand the opportunities for our Scouts to learn about the environment, ecology, and water conservation. Later this fall, we will offer special sessions of the Environmental Science and Soil and Water Conservation Merit Badges at Camp Trask in Monrovia and at the Cabrillo Youth Aquatic Center in San Pedro. These badges will help Scouts on their trail to Eagle, but more importantly, the Scouts will gain a deeper understanding of the importance of the watershed, the effects of erosion and pollution, and what they can do to protect our most precious natural resource. Your recognition of Jeff Keitlinger will help these Scouts to prepare to be stewards of our ecosystem. To give you a sampling of this program, I would like to introduce you to some of our Scouts who worked on these merit badges last month while attending summer camp. Thanks for helping these Scouts and future Scouts make the world better by protecting and preserving our water supply.
Unfortunately, we don't necessarily have a lot of that down here in Southern California because Southern California is currently going through a drought.
So, like, what can we do to help?
I'm glad you asked. There's a couple of things we can do to help.
Always make sure you don't leave faucets running. Try to do full loads of laundry so you don't have to do them multiple times a day. Always set a timer whenever you take a shower. And reuse water whenever you can. process for turning water from water reservoirs into drinking water has quite a few steps. First, a pump draws water from the reservoir. Second, sediments are removed from water with coagulants that stick the sediments together, so they are easier to remove. These clumps of sediments are called flock. Flock is heavy, so it will sink to the bottom of the water supply. The water in the water supply will then pass through different filters to remove smaller particles. Finally, a disinfectant like chlorine is added to remove any remaining germs. From there, we have drinking water.
Unfortunately, everyone, our time today has come to a close, but I hope our discussion has inspired you to utilize your resources a lot more wisely so that way we can live on this earth for many years to come. All right, everybody, stand up. Let's head on out, guys. Let's go.
The experiences we provide to our scouts, the lessons they learn, and the values they embrace become the foundations of their life. If you want to know the difference that one scout can make, look no further than our honoree, Jeff Keitlinger. Jeff is an Eagle Scout and has dedicated his life to public service. Ryan Wong is a Life Scout from Troop 286 in Monterey Park. Ryan is working to make a difference in his community as he works on the BSA Distinguished Conservation Service Award. This award recognizes scouts who design a conservation project that achieves real, long-standing, significant impacts on the environment.
Hello, my name is Ryan Wong, and I have been a scout since the first grade. I am currently a Life Scout, and I'm working on the Eagle rank. I am also the Troop 286 Senior Patrol Leader. And today, we are at the Little Dalton Canyon. And over there, you can see the target of this project, which is the invasive species of reed, Arundo. It looks like bamboo. The end goal of this project is to inspire others to help preserve the culture and the memories that we have made in nature. That is why I have given myself to this cause, and that is why plenty of other scientists, researchers, and thinkers have also given their lives to this cause. Over here is the riverbed at Little Dalton Canyon, and it is the example of the watershed habitat that Arundo thrives in and invades. And that is one of the major problems that we have with Arundo. It's because this watershed habitat is so delicate and interconnected between organisms, making it extra vulnerable to Arundo. The use of herbicide would be detrimental to this ecosystem and environment, because if you use it at Arundo, it would seep through and not only go to the riverbed and kill other plants, but go into the underground water reservoirs as well. I'm inspired for this project because of the brotherhood of scouts. I and many other scouts have learned lots from nature. We have created bonds that no other school activity, club, or sport has created. And this is all because we are in nature when we camp and hike and do all of these activities. Another more important motivator for me was Dr. Anne Croissant. She was the president of the San Gabriel Mountain Regional Conservancy. She devoted her life to conservation, and really, I see a part of myself in her. But sadly, she passed away before we could finish this project, and that's really one of the main motivators, is finishing this project for her. This project has three major components. The first component is the actual project site, which is the eradication of Arundo on the hillside. The second component is the blog, which is, in layman's terms, so that people can use the process that we have created for this project anywhere around the world. And the third component is the scientific paper, which will support the effectiveness of the blog and the process. Now, this is only a small step in the change needed to protect the environment and to preserve this culture, but is a step that is needed. In a small sense, this project will give back to others by providing a scientific paper as well as a blog so that everybody can use the process that we have created during this project elsewhere to remove Arundo in their community. The other objective is to inspire others to continue to combat Arundo and prevent it from growing elsewhere and invading, as it is truly detrimental to watersheds around the world. This project is water conservation related because Arundo uses much of the water, both above ground and underground, in the underground reservoirs. It prevents water from seeping into the watersheds and collecting so that other organisms and whatnot can use it. I want to thank Jeff Neitlinger for his contributions to scouting and water conservation. You are an inspiration to all of us.
As a young scout, Jeff visited Philmont Scout Ranch, attended a National Scout Jamboree, and climbed many peaks, including Mount Whitney. His son, Desi, was also active in scouting and served as a counselor at both GLAAC, BSA Scout Camps, Trask, and Cherry Valley. Tonight we honor an outstanding and iconic leader who has done so much for our community over the past few decades by giving of his time, his service and commitment to water conservation, and its environmental impact on all of our communities, Los Angeles County and nationwide.
We always felt working with Jeff that if he promised, he would deliver, and he did. Jeff, we've had a great working relationship over the years. I'd say almost 20 years when you're the council and this, obviously as general manager. It's been a pleasure to work with you and deal with you over that time. And I know whatever you do in the future, it's not over. I mean, you're younger than me, for God's sake, that you'll do very well.
The Distinguished Citizens Award recipient sums up our honoree, who can combine his bold vision with the mission of the Metropolitan Water District, which is to provide its service area with adequate, reliable supplies of high-quality water to meet the present and future needs in an environmentally and economically responsible way.
There's no doubt that Jeff has been quite a leader in Southern California, because Jeff had the foresight and the tenacity and the political skills to get done what needed to be done. So Jeff, coming from a longtime California family, with those memories, those images, all of that creates a power and a foundation, a pillar that gives real definition and perspective. I mean, that does give you a sense of continuity. It gives you a sense of the big picture, the long term.
A distinguished citizen masked with leadership skills is a powerful force and is rare and getting more rare in society today. A distinguished citizen is a person that any parent could use as an example to hold up to their community, their church, and to their children.
I'm happy to be celebrating Jeff Keitlinger as the recipient of the Distinguished Citizen Award. Having worked closely with him as a Metropolitan Board member, I saw firsthand how he exemplifies the value of public service and the Boy Scouts. Trustworthy, honest, and a leader. If there were a merit badge for pioneer and visionary in the water world, Jeff would have earned it many times. My heartfelt congratulations to Jeff on this award.
I recently heard a touching story about Jeff Keitlinger and wanted to share that a seemingly small but kind deed can make an extraordinary impact on someone's life and success of their career. A few years back, Jeff met with one of his farming constituents from Blythe, California, and his daughter, who had just graduated from dental school. Jeff invited them up to the 12th floor of the Met building to his office to sit down for an impromptu meeting. In the middle of the conversation, Tiffany turned to Jeff to discuss her future and asked for career advice. She had two options: one, to set up a dental practice at a prestigious location in Los Angeles, or two, set up her practice in her hometown of Blythe, California. She asked Jeff for his honest opinion. Jeff couldn't have been more enthusiastic and supportive about her setting up her practice in Blythe and being one of her choices, and told her that great things would continue to happen in this small agricultural town, and that MWD continued their support of the Palo Verde Valley along with the Colorado River Valley region. 2 years later, Tiffany's dental practice is thriving, and she nor her father will ever forget the kindness Jeff extended to them. She is now the only homegrown native that is practicing dentistry in Blythe. Just one small act of kindness, one good turn each day, is taught to all scouts at a young age. Imagine having that imprinted into your thought process as a youth. It inevitably becomes a way of life as an adult. As an Eagle Scout, Jeff practices the Scout Law in everyday encounters such as this and makes a profound impact.
It is a pleasure to congratulate my dear friend and valued colleague, Metropolitan's former general manager, Jeff Keitlinger. Jeff certainly left his mark on our agency, and he influenced the discussion of water, not only in the state of California, but across the country in a very positive way. I am grateful for sharing a moment in time by his side, working together on so many important initiatives. Many congratulations, Jeff, on being recognized and honored by the Boy Scouts for this fitting tribute.
The Scout Law embodies the following: trustworthy, loyal, helpful, friendly, courteous, kind, obedient, cheerful, thrifty, brave, clean, and reverent.
I'm honored to recognize my predecessor at Metropolitan, Jeff Keitlinger. During his 25-year career at our agency, he fulfilled the highest ideals of the Boy Scouts in his dedicated service. He served with integrity and leaves behind an impressive legacy of securing a reliable water supply for Southern California. We are all grateful for that. Many congratulations, Jeff, on being recognized as the Boy Scouts of America Greater Los Angeles Council Distinguished Citizen of 2021. I salute you.
I am now proud to ask Scouting Chairman and President John Johnson to present the 2021 Distinguished Citizens Award to Eagle Scout Jeff Keitlinger.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Greater Los Angeles Area Council is proud to present the Distinguished Citizen Award to Jeff Keitlinger.
Jeff, congratulations.
Thank you very much, John. It's very special. Thank you.
Well, thank you, everyone. It's really an honor to be accepting the 2021 Distinguished Citizen Award from the Greater Los Angeles Area Council of the Boy Scouts of America. I want to thank the council for selecting me for this award. This really feels like coming full circle to be remembering my teen years in scouting at the end of my career at the Metropolitan Water District. Now, scouting is about serving and being part of the greater community. I was lucky to have some great experiences in my years of scouting. I attended the National Jamboree in Idaho. I visited Philmont Ranch in New Mexico. Got to hike the Silver Moccasin Trail, the Nine Peaks Trail, the John Muir Trail. We climbed Mount Baldy, San Jacinto, San Gorgonio, Mount Whitney, and many other mountains. I credit my involvement with scouting in teaching me the importance of community service, enjoying nature, protecting the environment. Scouting taught me teamwork, friendship, hard work, leadership. Scouting was a big part of my teenage years, and some of that carried through to my children, My youngest son, Desi, he spent his summers as a camp counselor at Camp Trask in the San Gabriel Mountains and Camp Cherry Valley on Catalina. Now, the life lessons I learned in scouting carried through in my career and the rest of my life. I always wanted to work in public service, and that was because of scouting. I've been fortunate these past 25 years to work for the Metropolitan Water District. The mission of Metropolitan is to ensure that Southern California has sufficient water to sustain the 19 million people that live here. Our mission of providing that essential service to the public while working with nature and protecting the environment, that's in keeping with the basic principles of scouting. Now, we all know the Boy Scout motto is be prepared. And most of us know California and the entire American Southwest is in the middle of a historic drought. Yet Southern California, we're not in panic mode. We aren't implementing emergency rationing. And that's because Metropolitan follows that motto to be prepared. We plan for these type of events. That motto of being prepared is probably the most important aspect of scouting that I learned and that I applied to my career. Now, I want to thank everyone that attended this event tonight. Your contributions are going to be used to provide that scouting experience to underprivileged kids that otherwise would not get to experience hiking, nature, and getting out of the city. I specifically want to thank the sponsorship committee that was co-chaired by Gloria Gray and Cynthia Kurtz. And I want to thank our host for tonight's event, Richard Katz. It was their hard work, along with the rest of the sponsorship committee, that's going to help so many young men and women. As I said, this really feels like coming full circle to receive this award from the Boy Scouts to recognize my work with Metropolitan. Now, speaking of coming full circle, my youngest son and I decided to climb Mount Whitney last month to mark my retirement. And I can tell you, it was a lot harder now than it was 40 years ago. Thank you again, Greater LA Area Council, for this award. And I want to thank everyone for your generosity tonight. It was for a very, very good cause. So thank you all. I appreciate this and good night.
Thank you to our 2021 Distinguished Citizen, Jeff Keitlinger. Let's again thank Scout Ryan Wong for sharing his conservation journey with us.
And finally, thank you all for joining us for our first virtual Distinguished Citizen Award ceremony honoring Jeffrey Keitlinger. Thank you to our honorary committee co-chairs, Gloria Gray and Cynthia Kurtz, and the entire honoree committee for their hard work making this event a huge success. We have raised thank you to all of our generous sponsors and supporters, and thank you for helping to build character and leadership in today's youth, who will be tomorrow's leaders. Good night.